Hello. I hope you are doing well. Welcome to a playthrough of the game Outlast. And we will start a new game. And we'll put it on normal. Outlast contains intense violence, gore, graphic sexual content, and strong language. Please enjoy. You are Miles Upshur, an investigative reporter whose ambition is about to earn him an intimate tour of hell on earth. Always willing to risk digging into the stories no other journalist would dare investigate, you will seek out the dark secret at the heart of Mount Massive Asylum. Stay alive as long as you can. Record everything. You are not a fighter. To navigate the horrors of Mount Massive and expose the truth, your only choices are to run, hide, or die. And just so you know, I did play this all the way through a couple years ago. Back around, I don't know, 2016, something like that.
Department of Agriculture Commissioner Salazar said changing weather patterns were to blame for livestock behavior and encouraged ranchers and breeders to attend this weekend seminar on Beulah Avenue in Pueblo.
Well, let's just put the subtitles on.
And if you're out late tonight, you may see some low-flying helicopters near Silverthorn and Leadville. Seems the Arapaho Park Services will be spraying for an infestation of box elderbugs. But do keep all pets and children indoors between the hours.
Must just be some bad reception. Mount Massive Asylum. I'm gonna have to consider doing a roleplay of some sort based on this game. No one's there at the booth. I guess it's just after hours, I guess. They went home. September 17th, 2013, from some number at mutemail.com to Miles Upshur. Subject, tip/illegal activity at Murkoff Psychiatric Systems. You don't know me. Have to make this quick. They might be monitoring. I did 2 weeks of software consult at Murkoff Psychiatric Systems facilities in Mount Massive. All sorts of NDAs I am very much breaking right now, but seriously, fuck those guys. Terrible things happening there. Don't understand it. Don't believe half the things I saw. Doctors talking about dream therapy going too deep, finding something that had been waiting for them in the mountain. People are being hurt, and Murkoff is making money. It needs to be exposed. Well, glad I'm here. I'm the man for it. Got my camcorder, my two batteries. Let's do this. My press badge. Objectives are updated in your reporter's notebook containing your notes and picked up documents. And yes, based on those icons, I am playing on the PS4. Just so you know, in case you weren't aware, I used to be a PC, part of the PC Master Race. but I've spent so many years behind a desk at various jobs, and I spend still a lot of hours editing my videos, that I no longer like to sit in front of the computer because it just reminds me of work. And I don't like sitting in front staring at a screen. So I don't think we're going in that way. Okay, so square to open. And just, okay, here's my camcorder. Oh, and I recorded an event. Save my battery. Let's see what the notes. I start feeling sick just looking at this place. Mount Massive Asylum, shut down amid scandal and government secrecy in 1971, reopened by Murkoff Psychiatric Systems in 2009 under the guise of a charitable organization. Cell phone reception cut off abruptly a mile out. More like a jammer than lost signal. The Murkoff Corporation has a long track record of disguising profit as charity, but never on American soil. Whatever they thought they could get out of this place has to be big. Might finally be the story that breaks the bastards. Alright. Notes are only out of your notebook when your camcorder is raised to record events. Okay. Probably just had to get a drink of water. Whoever that was. To run, L1. So yeah, I'm not gonna play this once every month. Just in case you're new to these Let's Plays of mine. And just to refresh your memory if you're not. This is the fourth game slot. Which means I rotate the game played in this slot every month. Last month it was Darkest Dungeon. This time it's Outlast. It looks like we're gonna go up there. And again, I have to give a shout out to whoever recommended this. I think when I started doing Let's Plays. Yeah, I knew that wasn't gonna be able to go in there. When I started doing Let's Plays like years ago, I think someone had joked, left a comment saying I should play Outlast, knowing that this game is anything but relaxing. So here we are. I thought it'd be kind of fun. I've always loved horror games, books, you name it. It's a beautiful place. Press X. Okay. Easy enough. And X to jump up. Okay. But as I've gotten older, I don't really watch. I'm not really into the horror stuff anymore. Video games is a little bit of a different. So far, seems to be a nice, peaceful place. Okay. Well, it must have just been a rat or something. Blood. Well, this is not mine. Yet. Okay. Just kind of looking for batteries. Batteries are used for the infrared light of your camcorder. You can reload by pressing the triangle. Okay, anything here I can interact with? I thought I could, but I guess not, huh? Let's go see what's in here. Notes, documents. we have the whistleblower. Or did that. Project Wall Rider patient status report for William Hope. Murkoff Psychiatric Systems Project Wall Rider. Mount Massive, Colorado, case number 174. Patient initials WPH Billy. Consultation dated, I think that's October 14th, 2012. Initial date of patient consult, April 2009. 19 years old, male. Observing physician, Dr. Carl Houston. DBNR. Therapy status. Patient claims to have progressed to self-directed lucid dream states. Morphogenic engine activity observed at unprecedented scale. Continuing stage 4 hormone schedule. Diagnostics. Spirometry revealed no bronchial accumulation. Hematocrit. I'm not really sure how to pronounce some of these words. Centrifuge again failed to separate erythrocytes. Highly worrisome. MRI revealed a rhythmic REM-NREM cycle. Laughter in NREM state. Interview notes. Billy asked about the status of his mother's lawsuit against Murkoff and the asylum. This represents a catastrophic breach in security. Despite Billy's claims that he discovered the truth in the blood dreams of Dr. Traeger. Note, the only Traeger on company records, one Richard Traeger, is an executive from MRD. All orderlies and security personnel must be questioned and video security improved to include analytical biometrics. Murkoff Psychiatric Systems Project Wall Rider. Not massive company. All right, I think that's enough of this room. They really should do something about their lighting system. Okay. It's the bathroom. Well, somebody's gotta go. You gotta go, you know? Oh. Must be nothing. Oh, that looks, I like sausage. Looks pretty good, tasty. I'm kind of hungry. Okay. Oh, it looks like that doesn't look too good. I don't think. Let's see. Can I get up there? Okay. I wonder if I should have recorded. I'm not really sure. I want to record her. What not to record? I thought there was hints. Some kind of notification. Thank you. Well, I'm not going that way. I think that is the main entrance. Yeah, it doesn't look too good down there. Okay. Hey, let's go to the library. Yeah. Got me again. That got me the very first time I played this game, and okay. Oh, this is not very cool. Not very cool at all. I just want to make sure I'm not missing any batteries. A lot of heads. Okay. Alright, good. I had an extra body. I had an extra battery. I think I loaded an extra battery by accident earlier. Bathroom. Okay. I don't think I'm going to be using that toilet. All right. Nobody wants me to go in there. I guess not. No worries. Sure, there's a perfectly rational explanation for everything going on. Just a misunderstanding. Don't think we're going in there. Alright. Another squeeze through.
Little thing. And who are you, then? I see. Merciful God, you have sent me an apostle. Guard your life, son. You have a calling.
Well, then. That was quite an unfortunate series of events. New objective. Escape the asylum. Access security control to unlock the blah blah blah. Okay. Okay, there we go. Access security control to unlock the main doors. Oh, sounds easy enough. I'm inside. I'm inside. Bodies everywhere. Blood. Burn marks. Heads lined up like bottles behind a bar. Dead Murkoff scientists hung from the ceiling. Their badges say, Murkoff Advanced Research Systems. Murkoff's longtime MO has been to profit off the exploitation of supposed charity. Fuck the third world and bankroll another billion. How did Murkoff think they would make money off a building full of crazy people? There's some kind of tactical cop pinned like a pig on a spit, tells me to get the fuck out, and then dies. Would have been a good thing to hear when I could still leave the way I came. And I think that's it so far. Okay. That's not good. And that's not good. Proclaim the gospel. Can I just... That's probably all wired. Wires and glass. God, I'm not getting out that way. Slashing through the action, returning the reaction, weaker ripped and torn away. Hypnotizing power, crossing all the cower, battery is here to stay. Okay. Load a new battery. Surprises in here. Yeah. I guess I'm not using that toilet. Okay. And I'm not going in there. Guess. It's such a relaxing sound, isn't it? Just walking on the glass, broken. broken shards of glass. Just trying to relax, calm down after everything I've seen so far. Okay. What we got here? Oh, I'm actually like crawling around in it. Yeah, I don't think you'd put my hand on that. Yeah, not a good idea. Oops. Trying to feed the water the plants, and I guess the plant ate his head. Hey, what's up, man? You okay? No? Okay. Any batteries? Document. The Murkoff Corp. United States Office. Warrant for seizure. Case number blah blah blah. In the matter of the seizure of Mount Massive Psychiatric Center. Blah blah blah. Affidavits have been made before the board of directors by Murkoff Hardline Security, MHS. Who has reason to believe catastrophic security failure of psychiatric center with imminent danger of environment contamination. We are satisfied that the affidavits and testimony establish sufficient evidence to require urgent action to the part of MHS and grounds for the issuance of this warrant. You are hereby required to grant MHS full access to all facilities and surrender complete authority to its agents. By acceptance of this document, you and any surviving relatives surrender all claims of litigation against the Murkoff Corp. or its subsidiaries for the actions of MHS or the circumstances which required their actions, regardless of responsibility. Okay, Murkoff Hardline Security. So, Murkoff's own security attempted to come in here and do whatever. It's interesting. Murkoff owns the place, but then it had to send its own security people in. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, so we have an elevator, and we have blood. Okay, and we have stairs going down, which I'm not too keen on going down just yet, and we're not getting in there, so that looks interesting. But no dice. Okay. I guess we're going this way. Let's see what do we have. Floor one. Security room. Electric room. Library. Recreation hall. Cafeteria. Chapel. Okay. Where's the pool? Okay. I'm not sure what the hell it's about, but Clyde Perry, Director of Historical something, Oliver Baranchik, Assistant Director of Behavioral Medicine. Who was that? Something. Can't read that one. Silex. something. And then Jermaine Dallaire. Colonic hydrotherapy. Colon cleaning. Well, there was quite a lot of blood in this room. I see. Lots of body parts and whatnot. Okay. Well, things didn't go too well for these folks. Security, I guess, and maybe scientist or something. Lots of organs and yum yums. Well, yum yums for someone else. I just want like a burger, some fries, maybe a milkshake. Oh, gee. Whatever could be behind these stalls. I don't really want to open this one, but okay. Witness him going to the bathroom. Is that it? Oh, I recorded something. The witness. I'm already beat all to hell. Picking broken glass out of my scalp. Couple cracked ribs. Nearly killed by a deformed giant. Looks like someone who tried to fuck start his head with a cheese grater. He throws me through a wall. Knocks me unconscious. I wake up in some doughy old man with a face like an alcoholic kiddie fiddler in a homemade priest outfit. Calls me his apostle. Not a job I asked for. There are words scrawled in blood everywhere. I'm getting an ugly feeling in my gut that the priest is writing them, and for my benefit. Okay, let's see. And the winner is a foot. Or is that a hand? It's a hand, again. In a toilet bowl. That's not the kind of decor I personally would go for. This door needs a key card. Okay. No problem. At least nobody's dead in there. And that's the room I think somebody ran into. I'm going in here. And I'm gonna close this door. Could you please? Why are you not? Not the way I meant to close it. Okay, what do we have here? Not the best way to go with your head twisted all around. Well, we got a document. From Helen Granat to group blah 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 at Murkoff Corp. Subject: Project Wall Rider on Site Inspection. Dear Sirs, the full report pending. No immediate action is required on the part of the Murkoff Corp. The profit potential of Project Wall Rider remains staggeringly high. The four fatalities contain enough ambiguous data to make any litigation, if evidence is correctly managed, impossible. Project Wallrider remains a dangerous initiative, and there will almost certainly be further casualties. As with the others, however, family and government interest in the patients is so low as to make any chance of legal actions vanishingly unlikely. Violence among patients is increasing as the morphogenic engine therapy gets closer to producing working models, but a combination of physical and chemical restraints has proven sufficiently effective to assure continued control and profit. Respectfully, Helen Granat, Murkoff Legal Mitigation Department. All right. There is anything else going on? Okay. Are we gonna? Bummer.
We didn't choose this. Why should we have to pay for it? Why do we have to die? Walker will kill us just for being sick. We're still people. We didn't choose this.
Okay. Just wanted to see if there was anything to record that I might be missing. Alright, I guess we're going down. I don't think he has a key card. Going down. Okay, what am I missing? There. How many still alive? Looking for batteries. Luckily, there's enough light. I'm sure that's how they planned it. Psychiatric Systems, Project Wallrider, patient initials CLW Walker, 32-year-old male, observing physician Dr. Rudolph Wernick, notation by Dr. Walsh, therapy status, morphogenic engine activity plateaued at roughly 2000 ppm, unsafe to progress beyond stage 3 hormone schedule, diagnostics. Barometry revealed light to medium bronchial accumulation. MRI scans consistent with patient's reported dreams. Interview notes. Walker was interviewed in restraints following his self-inflicted mutilations. Restraint have had to be altered to accommodate his enormous size. Extensive dermal eruptions as consistent with failed morphogenic engine cellular activity. He claims the skin ripped from his forehead allows for a truer way of seeing. Seems to have some boyhood experience with Tuatara lizards and their parietal eyes. He has expressed anxiety about his flesh, specifically around his lips and nose. Attending orderlies should be advised to watch for further self-mutilation. The mental traumas he sustained while serving in Afghanistan seem to be retarding progression of the ME process. His predominant fixation, amplified by therapy, is a manic exaggeration of military security protocol. A continuation of both chemical and physical restraints is highly recommended. And that was the big guy that we saw. Pretty sure. Okay. Oh, I can peek. Okay. Which way did I come in? That way. Let's peek. Alright. So we're on this side. pretty messed up. More notes. Broken men in dead television. A crowd of broken men watching a dead channel. They look like patients. They survived whatever happened here, but nobody's home. I got the key card. Collected objects. Okay. I can't imagine trying to play this game through on. I guess they got to them in here anyway. Okay. Anything interesting on the cameras? Everything looks copacetic, I think. Alright, let's unlock the main doors. I love how, like, I'm a reporter and, like, I know how to access their system. Uh-oh. Great. I'm not in the locker. Keep going. No one's here. There you go. You big sexy beast. Bagger. I'm not really scared of you at all. Okay. Gotta go to the basement. Alright, well, I think we've been playing this for about an hour already. And, I think we'll end it here and pick up, maybe, if any of you want me to see me continue this. Where did he go? Did he go in there? And did he go this way? I don't know. He just do one of those magical NPC disappearance into a section of the game that I can't yet. Okay, anyway. Yeah, so we'll pick up. We'll play this again in a couple months or so. And like I said in another gameplay, let's play, I wish I could do more of these more often. I just really can't. So, alright, well, thanks for watching. I hope you found this relaxing. I know I sure did. And yeah, that's where we're going next. It's open. Alright. So you take care of yourself. Until next time. And, alright. Saving there. Alright, we'll pick up. We'll read one last document. And that'll do it. For this playthrough. See what we have. MK-Ultra program, which was an actual thing. CIA document number 190691. I want excerpt 2, file, subject hypnotic experimentation and research. February 10th, 1954. On Wednesday, 10 February 1954, hypnotic experimentation and research work was continued in Building 13 of the Mount Massive Preserve in Colorado using the following subjects. Material abridged. 1. A post-hypnotic of the night before, pointed finger, you will sleep, was enacted. Mrs. Jackson and Pierce immediately progressed to a deep hypnotic state with no further suggestion. Miss Pierce was then instructed, having previously expressed a fear of firearms in any fashion, that she would use every method at her disposal to awaken Miss Jackson, now in a deep hypnotic sleep, and failing this, she would pick up a nearby pistol and fire it at Miss Jackson. She was instructed that her rage would be so great that she would not hesitate to kill Jackson for failing to awaken. 2. Miss Pierce carried out these suggestions to the letter, including firing the unloaded pneumatic pistol gun at Jackson and then proceeding to fall into a deep sleep. After proper suggestions were made, both were awakened and expressed complete amnesia for the entire sequence. Miss Pierce was again handed the gun, which she refused, in an awakened state, to pick up or accept from the operator. She expressed absolute denial that the foregoing sequence had happened. Very interesting. Okay, we're just gonna fade out here, so, like I said, talk to you soon, stay well, and I hope to see you in another video real soon.